I have a feeling that we're not going to get any mail delivery today. And the reason I say that is because, you see, snow. I had a doctor's appointment today, which I canceled because the daytime person who comes to watch my mother couldn't make it because of the snow. So I've rescheduled my doctor's appointment, and but I'm anxious about the mail delivery because there's a book I'm rather anxious about. This is the new catalog for Centipede Press, and here's my book, Tangled Muse. I think there's only 3 copies left, so I don't know why he put that in there. Anyway, the resurrection, the agonizing resurrection of Victor Frankenstein by Thomas Ligotti. This is a collection of his prose poems, gothic, they're mostly gothic prose poems, illustrated by Harry O. Morris. An amazing book, and Jared sent me a gift copy of it about 2 months ago, and that book never arrived. And it's a book I was so excited. I have not read it, and I've ached to read it. The initial paperback edition is selling at Amazon for, I think, around $500. So this is a beautiful new hardcover printing, up to Centipede Press standards, amazing standards, and signed by Thomas Ligotti. I was really depressed at the idea that I wouldn't be able to read it. And then I was doing a search on Centipede Press books. Yeah, oh, there's somebody in the sled. Isn't that kid? They have a lot of kids in this neighborhood. Snow. Someone almost fell down. No, I completely forgot my train of thought. Anyway, I was doing a search at Amazon.com of Centipede Press titles, and I found that they were selling copies of the Ligotti book there. And then I ordered it, and the bloke selling them was Thomas Ligotti. So he's going to sign it for me, and he's already sent it. So as soon as it arrives, I am going to open it here, live on YouTube. I was thinking of doing an extreme makeup, but I don't really have the energy to do really big makeups anymore. So I've got to go check the pizza. We're having pizza for dinner. Hang on one sec. I think it's nearly done. So very excited about that book. I wish it hadn't snowed, because I think the snow is going to mean that we're not having mail delivery today. Have you guys read this book, The Dream World of H.P. Lovecraft, by Donald Tyson? I read it and it really annoyed me. I tried to read some of it again today and Mr. Tyson simply does not understand Lovecraft, and most of what he says about Lovecraft to me seems wrong-headed and not true. He thinks that Lovecraft was a visionary, because I suppose Tyson would be called an occultist, Lovecraft, the rationalist, dismissed the importance of his dreams and of the stories based upon them. He pretended to himself that they were no more than a facile entertainment. Lovecraft never considered his fiction facile entertainment, a way of distracting the mind from the tedium and pointlessness of material existence. And Tyson is trying to emphasize that Lovecraft was a visionary artist who dismissed his art. Lovecraft never dismissed his art. He was a literary artist who knew exactly what he was trying to accomplish. He was a very serious artist. And that's the thing that people who claim the Necronomicon is a real book, and that Lovecraft's dreams are real and his gods are real, they diminish the truth about Lovecraft, is that he was a supreme artist in literature. And that is so important to me, that he be acknowledged as one of our genre's finest writers, with a keen imagination and a genius for translating that imagination into classic tales of weird fiction. But then Lovecraft was more than merely a dreamer. Night after night, he engaged in intuitive astral projection. He became consciously aware in at least some of his more vivid dreams, and gained a measure of control over his perception of those dream dramas. This is just bullshit. But the thing that really irritates me about this book is that Tyson goes on to emphasize what he sees as Lovecraft's oddness, to emphasize that Lovecraft was a freak of nature. And in the introduction he says, for one thing, he was odd, not odd in the usual sense, but truly alien from the rest of the human race. He was always the outsider, unlike many of those outside the circles of popular society who gaze at them longingly and seek to break in. Lovecraft had no interest in other human beings, and very little use for them. He regarded other people as elements of the general landscape, with the same lack of involvement with which he regarded stones and trees. That's bullshit. We have a record of Lovecraft's interaction with people in this Arkham House book, Lovecraft Remembered. It's a thick book of recollections of people to whom Lovecraft mattered in some way, and I think people that mattered to Lovecraft as friends, associates, fellow artists, he was involved with humanity intensely. And part of that intense involvement is reflected in Lovecraft's selected letters. We have an almost day-by-day record written by Lovecraft of his life in his collected letters. And I fear that Donald Tyson, as a Lovecraft biographer, is a complete failure. That's my humble opinion. Okay, pizza is ready. I wish you all a wonderful, wonderful day. And I'm really getting bugged by the high whine noise in my videos. Some have said that it's the fan in my computer that's doing it. I don't know. It makes me not want to record videos anymore. Because there's that high whining that is such a distraction and an annoyance. I hate it. Alright. Time to feed me family. Shalom, my darling.